Welcome to a new teardown and test video. This time it's a... I wouldn't really call it handheld vacuum tube voltmeter, but it's actually a multimeter, because it's not only volts it will measure. It will measure AC volts and ohms and DC voltage, of course. So yeah, I think this is the three things it can measure. And look at this really sexy test probe for DC voltages. So it's nice and shielded. There is a 1 mega ohm resistor in here. So that is good for maybe protection or loading of the circuit you are measuring on. And it seems to be having a pretty good contact when you screw this on here. So far so good. There's a trimmer here for AC balance when you're measuring AC volts. You need to trim this. And what else can I say about this before we power it up? Yeah, it is model K-142. And what I found out, there's also a 1420 with a zero here. And it looks very much like this. Small and minor changes on the front here, and a little bit of changes as well on the meter itself. And before I power this up, I was doing a little bit of research, and I, of course, as always, go to radiomuseum.org. You can find schematics of all sorts of old good stuff, and it's very, very useful when you're messing around with good old things. I see two radio tubes. Three filaments, but I see something else, and that is this battery. Oh no, so there's a battery inside. That means I definitely need to open it before I power it up. So now we're inside this beautiful vacuum tube voltmeter. And yes, we see those two tubes, so that's pretty cool. And the first thing I see is this battery. And I just measured the voltage and it's 1.55 volts, so it's brand new. I really would like to know when was this installed or when was this instrument used for the last time. But that is not normal to find a battery that is brand new inside stuff like this. I'm always afraid of batteries inside units like this. I expected a lot worse. Okay, the plastic is a little bit cracked on each side there, so that is a little bit bad, but that is possible to fix. It has also been fixed with a little bit of resistor, new trimmer there, so that looks good. The first thing that shook my mind was this is mains cable. It comes to each of these sides of this. And this one is actually just to solder this wire together with that wire that goes to the transformator. And this one is the on-off switch. But what? And now it is in on, as you can see. So if I dial it down to off, okay, all is fine. So let's go to on. And if we continue... Look at this distance here. So this is a less than 1 millimeter between the mains input when the unit is on. Also, I have never seen this done before. All those wires, and they are on the flying or the moving the shaft of the both of the switches, and it's connecting all metal parts together with ground and everything. So this reveals that this meter is really, really sensitive, high impedance kind of stuff. I cleaned the switches a little bit, and on all of them I had some green nasty corrosion. So you can actually see a little bit of this green stuff left. I just, you know, sucked up the worst using a few of these. And it was like nasty. And what is that? That is a resistor that used to be a resistor, and it is now mounted with a new, nicely red one. So it has been fixed. That is a little overload, I guess. So that is what happens when you give it too much voltage in a low voltage setting, I guess. Let's see what kind of setting that is. So if this resistor that is blown is connect, this is exactly where we are, right? So that connect is there, right? So that will be 1.5 volt setting. And then you give it how many volts maybe to make this happen? A little bit more, I guess. Cap poof. Yeah, of course, this is what happens. Come on. This is what, 60 years old or something. 50, 60 years old. So of course, stuff like this must happen. It's quite beautiful, this capacitor. Look how the metal goes in and out there like that. It's beautifully made. And this is a special quality tube. Yay, we like it. Made in Japan. It also says made in Japan on the outside. But since the battery is working, I'm actually going to test this and see how well it works. It is not so visible now because I've been cleaning up everything here. But all the metal around the negative was actually wet. I don't know if I can... I did actually clean it up quite well. But everything on both sides of this and everything here was absolutely wet. And then I took out the battery, and it was also completely wet here on the negative side. But else, it looks almost brand new. But then I looked at this. Ooh, used by 2011. So that is 11 years ago. It was supposed to be used before that. And I think when you buy a new one, it is like 4 or 5 years until the use by date. So that means this one could be about 15 years old, this cell, and there's still 1.55 volts on it. That is a little bit amazing. So we're ready to power this up and see if it works. Mains is applied. And I turn the... Ooh, that's difficult. Then it's your power on. 9 watts. 7, so it goes down. So I want to try. Ooh. I want to try ohms first. This lamp is on. So if we turn on the off the light here, we should see this is from where I'm standing. It's really nice and bright. So I like that. So we're now in ohms, and it is open, as you can see. There's no... Okay, let's try. Okay, so this one is the zero. And this is also... This is a little bit confusing because we've got two of them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in a set of wires here. And I'm going to short the wires. Aha, see? Shorted wires goes to zero. So that will be one of them. That will be the zero. Okay, and then it's open. Then I go to open, I guess. Let's try again. Zero. And then open the other one, I guess. What do I know? This one says zero, so So I would guess this is what I need to do, right? How many times do I need to go back and forward? Okay, now this is absolutely zero, so that is great. So that works. Now I'm gonna try and take a 1K resistor. And it says 100 times 10. So that is 1K. Hey, see, that works. Haha. That is not so bad either. Let me see. So this is times 100. And it is 10 up there. It's okay, it's actually 9.5 it's reading. So in this range, let me try again. So open is that one. It is adjusted for exactly open. And we try and sort circuits over, take the other side. Oh, see? And then I remove, adjust the zero. Until that is absolutely zero. And again, open is now too much. Okay, so you need to go and do this in every range. Okay, and then this is 1K, and it is very, very close. Just under the 10 here. So, I mean, it seems like it's working. That is not too bad. And I didn't get electrocuted, no. So that was ohms. So we got DC positive and DC negative. We got AC. So what is the next? Let's try some DC. This is the DC probe or the DC input. DC positive. So that will be 15 volts, I guess. And then I don't touch these. So DC. Then I don't use this one anymore, right? Let me hook something up here. So, I think I am ready. What I did is, okay, DC range, I think this is the 15 volts range. Let me try and give it 12 volts. Yeah. Let me see, where are we? The 15 range, ooh, AC and DC. Oh, there's another, so okay, it must be this one. Oh, it's reading way too little. Let me try and turn this off again. Did it go to zero? Yeah, okay, it goes to zero. But the 10 volt range, or the 15 volt range. Okay, so let's go 15, 50. Okay, this is the 50 volt range, so that will be the next one. And then it is again reading a lot too little. Let's go to 20 volts of input, and then now it's reading 15. Okay, so it's definitely something with the something with the voltages that's a little bit too low. And then DC minus, what is that? That is just, is that reversing the input just by? Yes, it definitely is. So let me try and see what happens. I go to DC negative, and then I reverse the input. Did you guys see that? Now it's almost that is a lot better. How is that possible? How is this reversing actually working? So maybe there's something with this circuit that has something to do with that. That is affecting the accuracy. See? Oh, okay. Look, there's a something with zero. So there's an offset in this circuit. It's not affecting it by this. Ooh! Whoa! Zero adjust. Okay, so zero adjust. Oh my goodness. So you need to poke around with zero. Also, if you... Ooh, yoy. So zero is not just an ohm thing. It is a... always a thing. Okay, what did we know? So that was 15. Okay, this way. So we go DC negative, and then we trim a little bit here, and then we use the... Yeah, but now it reads 18, and that is 20 volts. Anyway, there's a little bit of something, but it's not completely dead or a defect or anything. It just needs a little bit of love and some trimming and and stuff, so I'm definitely not going to throw this away. But I think somebody else should be able to continue with this actually sexy-sized meter. You can really, really easily read the values and stuff. Even from a meter's distance, you can easily see what's going on here. Or I think it's more, today it's more a collector's item, isn't it? By the way, it contains tubes and stuff. So I think it's quite sexy, but I will of course remember to remove the battery when I pack this bag for long time storage. And I really, really recommend everybody to do that always, so we don't see those meltdown batteries ruining products, okay?